Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. You're watching Kyle's vlog. I'm Kyle, and today we're looking at a palette, an eyeshadow palette. So basically, this is the box it came in. I bought it from someone I follow on Instagram, who's a really great artist, and she made this palette. It came in this box. And then this is the palette itself. I pronounce it Claro Psyche, but I've heard other people pronounce it Claro Psyche. I prefer to call it Psyche's Box instead of Psyche's Box. So I'm calling it Psyche's Box. These are the colors. It says classic and vibrant shades to create whatever you want, no rules. And then there's her logo and then her handle, Claro Psyche. So it's really beautiful. It has all these really vibrant colors in it. And it's great to just like have for fun, I think. I specifically got this because I'm going to see Lady Gaga in Las Vegas. I am going to the Enigma tour with my friend Mary Lou and her friend. And so I thought it'd be really fun to like do a look with some colors for that. And I thought, I've always kind of wanted this. It was $45, and then after shipping, it was like $50, which isn't bad. You get 12 colors. And so, like, yeah, I thought I'd just try to apply it in a video and make a video about it just because I want to give the product some more YouTube videos and help circulate this product because I think it's, like, really beautiful. And it just, I love the colors. They really resonate with me. It reminds me of watercoloring when you're a kid and children's colors in a way, but it's really nice. I even love the way they're arranged in the palette. So basically right now I just woke up. My skin isn't doing the best, unfortunately, but I washed my face. I put on moisturizer mixed with a little bit of BB cream, and then I filled in my eyebrows just a bit with Anastasia Beverly Hills eyebrow pencil. And then I only have these two brushes right now. I got them at Target. I talked about them in my last video. I kind of want to get a Packer brush. I don't know if this is a Packer brush or not. I need to learn more about brushes, basically, and I kind of want to get a couple more so I could apply this more precisely. You could kind of see I've already been playing with it, so there's like some residue still from before, but I just didn't wash my face the best, I guess. So it has a mirror, so you could kind of like see as you apply it. I think I want to try to go, I've been like playing around with the blues and greens so far, so I think I kind of want to do like this top line and do some of these warmer colors. So I guess starting out maybe with Baby Jane and then mixing in some Tic Tac and then finishing with the red and maybe doing some highlight with yellow and white. So I'm going to use my small brush here. It's just stained from the color before. I don't think there's any actual color still on it, and I think I'm just gonna do the whole lid and up into the crease. Okay, cool. I think that's nice. Just like maybe blur it out a little bit on the edge here. Maybe it should go even all the way up here. I do have this larger brush. I guess I could use this brush here for blending it up, just pushing it up. So I guess then probably I would want to start with some Tic Tac. Maybe I'll do the Tic Tac. I don't know. I'm not a makeup person, so I'm just have to experiment, and it may not turn out the best. But that's why we're here. So you could see how much pigment actually picks up onto the brush. It's really awesome. And then I think I'm gonna start just in the crease. Don't go looking for trouble these days. All grown up in a different place. Used to hang at the clubs and go wild. Okay, so that's something. Okay, it's definitely something. Let me go in with the red now and see. I think red, you know, it's kind of a classic color to put around your eyes. So, what if I just did it right here? That's something. I mean, it's mostly red, but you kind of get like the orange coming through, and there's some of the pink. Maybe adding some of the pink. Okay, yeah, there's definitely. Just imagine I don't have all these red zits, which I've had all week. I don't know why. And then, like I said, let's just keep pushing this a little bit. I'm gonna try to add some yellow. I guess that's just how my face is. It's not symmetrical, obviously. No one's face is perfectly symmetrical, but God attempts symmetry somehow. I don't know what it is about symmetry that denotes purpose or value. What I'm sort of realizing now is I could have used the white gossamer to make a base, kind of, and put the colors on top in order to make them even more pronounced. Or I think I also could have wet my brush to help make the colors brighter, but I'm new at this, so I'm just thinking of that now. But I'm gonna try to go in with some of the white and maybe right under the brow. And it's kind of cool that the white can kind of make the other colors lighter or more pastel. I've noticed that I probably should clean my brush or use the white first because other colors are kind of blending with it, but it's kind of like a highlight. If I just go right under my eye makeup here on my cheekbone, I could kind of use it like a highlighter on my cheek. Maybe I could also, I don't know. What if I use some of the pink on my nose? Okay, yeah, that's all. This has gone on way too long, so I didn't do amazing. We can catch a vibe, hanging on the couch on a Friday night, yeah, we can take a break. I feel like I could have done better, but it was just an experiment, and I just wanted to show you guys how pretty this was, and promo this product. So, yeah, thanks again for tuning in. I hope this one wasn't that boring, and you know, I'm trying to make more, but you know how life is, especially in America, it's not the easiest or the best, and it's kind of brutal, even for really privileged people like me. So, I'm not, yeah. So, bye.